Hi, I'm Bob from Harrison. Welcome to MIDI Basics for Mixbus. In this session, I'd like to record a keyboard performance, and I would also like to have a drum track to play along with. So let's first compose a simple drum track. I'm going to add a MIDI track by right-clicking in this blank area. In the Add Track dialog box, you can pre-select the virtual instrument you want to use from the pull-down menu. In the track header, you will see the Scroomer. This tool allows you to adjust the visible keyboard range. To start our drum track, using a general MIDI drum kit, we will focus on the keyboard range from C1 to C2, because that's where we'll find the kick drum and snare. It might be useful to set an initial tempo now, but I can change it at any time while working with MIDI. Just click in the clock window. We'll use 120 beats per minute. To build a MIDI drum track, you can use the Draw and Edit tools. You can then enable the grid and choose bar as the grid unit. Now you can use the Draw tool to create an empty MIDI region at bar number 2. Notice I left an open bar at the beginning for a count-in. Move the playhead and set the start marker to the beginning of the new region. I am going to change the note mode to percussive because we are working with drums and we only need to see the drum hits. Here's a cool trick when using MIDI drums. Change the device mode to general MIDI and set the MIDI channel to playback on channel 10. Now the general MIDI drum note labels will be displayed. Let's change the grid units to quarter notes so we can create a basic four-on-the-floor drum groove. To help find the sounds we are looking for, we can click on the keys to sound a note before we place it. When we add a new note, it is assigned a default velocity of 64. This and many other parameters can be changed at any time. Now that the first bar is finished, we can select and duplicate it. As we edit the velocity parameter of a note, the change will be applied to all of the duplicated bars. Notice the color of the note changes to represent the new velocity. In edit mode, you can use the mouse wheel to adjust the velocity of the selected note. And I'm just going to make a few more adjustments here. Now that I have a drum loop, I can lay down a keyboard track. Arm your new MIDI keyboard track and the master transport for recording. I can easily clean up the track if I need to. I'll delete this note and trim this one. Select the Grab tool and right-click on the region to see a list of MIDI region operations, including quantize and transpose. I think I will use 30 seconds to quantize the start and end of each note. And I also think I will transpose the performance up 2 semitones. I like the performance of the first bar, so I will delete the remaining bars and then duplicate the first one. MIDI editing is a relatively new feature in Mixbus, and we will be adding many new and powerful MIDI features in the future. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and join the Harrison Mixbus Forum.